ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग. गुड
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड
मॉर्निंग
मॉर्निंग
एवरीवन.
मैम।
हैप्पी मंडे. आई नो मंडेज आर नॉट सो गुड इवन फॉर मी, बट वी हैव टू, इज़न्ट इट? या, सो द सेमिनार्स, आर ऑल द सेमिनार्स ओवर? नो, राइट? अमल रोशन, आर यू रेडी टुडे? यस यस और नो? आई डिडंट हियर.
हाँ
यस, ओके. विल एनेबल स्क्रीन शेयरिंग, यू कैन शेयर.
स्क्रीन शेयर।
यस, यू कैन. अदर्स प्लीज कीप योर वीडियोस ऑन.
हम कैन यू सी
यस, आई कैन सी. रेस्ट ऑफ यू कैन सी, राइट? यस, ओके. गो स्लो, ओके अमल,
हाँ
गो स्लो. एक्सप्लेन द कॉन्सेप्ट्स एंड देन टेक.
गुड
यस,
आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी।
गुड आफ्टरनून.
आई एम हियर टू टेक ए टॉपिक ऑफ स्कूल्स ऑफ साइकोलॉजी पार्ट टू। आई एम हियर टू टेक ओनली फाइव टॉपिक्स स्कूल्स ऑफ साइकोनालिस ह्यूमन परसेप्टिव्स कंजेक्टिव परसेप्टिव एंड कंजेशन कंस्टर्वेटिज्म
वेट 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 वेट. कोग्निटिव पर्सपेक्टिव
कॉग्निटिव परसेप्टिव एंड
एंड द स्पेलिंग ऑल्सो यू हैव टू करेक्ट. कोग्निटिव इज COGNITIVE. ओके, यस, कंटिन्यू.
कॉग्निटिव परसेप्टिव।
कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म, ओके.
Here we are going to first topic psychoanalysis. You know that we have already studied this topic. Overview of a psychoanalysis, a set of philosophy of human nature. Psychoanalysis is both an approach to therapy and a theory of a personality. Emphasize unconscious motivation, the main
unconscious
unconscious
motivation.
motivation, the main cause of behavior lie in conscious mind.
Conscious or unconscious?
Unconscious mind.
Okay.
I am telling some important about explanation in psychoanalytics defined as a set of psychology theory and therapeutic techniques that have their origin in the work and the theories of Sigmund Freud. The core of psychoanalysis is the belief that all people possess unconscious thoughts, feelings, desires, and memories. In its definition, psychoanalytic theory is the theory of personality, organizations, and dynamic of personal development that guides psychoanalytic a method of clinic psychopathy.
Clinical psychopathy.
A analyze psychic phenomena treating emotional disorders. Main focus. All people focus on unconscious thoughts, feelings, desires, and memories. The repressed emotions and experience make the unconscious. The aim of psychoanalytic therapy is to release repressed emotional experiences. Basic theory can be experienced every day. Yes, basic theory is unconscious source of primitive sexual dependence and accuracy impulses. Why do we study psychoanalysis? On the recognition that individuals are often unaware of many of the factors that determine their emotions and behaviors. What you are expected from psychoanalysis? We are expecting that therapist spend time to listen for the patients, and then they solve the problems. What is the goal of psychoanalysis? The main of psychoanalytic therapy is to bring unconscious material to conscious and hence the function of the aid, helping the individual becomes less controlled by biological desires or demand of super goal.
Okay.
Then psychoanalyst emerge. Eco-psychology, modern conflict theory, object relation theory, self-psychology, adaptive paradigm, relation psychosome, everyday life psychoanalysis. Psychoanalysis, commonly we know that psychoanalysis commonly used to treat depression and anxiety disorders.
Is it?
In psychoanalysis therapy, if not, would have a patient lay on a couch to relax and would sit behind them taking notes while they told them. It's over. I'm here to talk about humanistic perspective.
Humanistic perspective. Okay.
A perspective that focuses on the study of unconscious, conscious experience and individual self-awareness and freedom to choose.
It's not unconscious, it's conscious here. In psychoanalysis, more focuses on unconscious. Here it is conscious. Okay, then.
Interested in the capacity for personal growth.
Yes.
These people as innately good, that is, fulfilled and healthy individuals rather than troubled people.
People.
People. The humanistic definition. Humanistic psychology is a psychology perspective that brought to prominence in the mid 20th century in answer to the limitations of psychological theory. Humanistic psychology is a pursuit that emphasizes looking at the whole person and the uniqueness of each individual humanistic.
Then that's all. Okay, continue.
Of each individual, humanistic psychology with the essential assumption that people have free will and are motivated to achieve their potential and self-actualize. What is the concept of humanistic psychology? Emphasis looking at the whole individual and stress concepts such as free will, self-efficiency and self-actualization.
Yes.
Each members of psychologists contribute to our understanding of human mind and behavior. Example of human psychology. Sensitive training at the place of employment is an example of the human sick perceived individuals are taught to value and respect. How is human sick psychology used? Human sick therapy is used to treat depression, anxiety, panic disorders, personalities disorders, sensory addiction, and relationship issues, including family relation problems.
Okay.
What is daily life about humanistic? Paying attention to the similarities between yourself and others. rather than the differences, recognition when others are in need and attempting to help, claiming responsibility our your own life.
Claiming responsibility to our own lives. Okay.
What do humanistic psychology focus on? How people are influenced by their self-perceptions and the personal meanings attached to their experiences.
Okay.
Important of humanistic promote God to heighten awareness and self-understanding, body-mind integration. Next, we are going to the slide of humanistic. Right. Morality, creativity, daily problem solving, lack of pressure, aspects of facts. Self-esteem, confidence, achievement.
Self-esteem, confidence,
confidence, achievement, respect of others, respected by others, friendship, family. Sexual intimacy, security of body, of employment, of result, of morality, of family, of health or property, breathing, food, water, sex, sleep, homeostatic excretion.
Homeostasis, excretion. Just a minute, Tamil. This is known as the Maslow's hierarchy or hierarchy of needs by Abraham Maslow. It is a theoretical concept. We discuss this concept generally in terms of humanistic theories. This is one of the humanistic theories. It is used as a theory of motivation. It is used as a theory of personality and so on. In different contexts it is applied. The concept is, there are five hierarchies mentioned here. That is physiological needs, safety needs, love or belongingness needs, esteem needs, and finally we reach self-actualization. So at the base we have the physiological or the biological needs, okay, and from there we attain all the needs, and then finally we reach the top of the hierarchy, that is self-actualization, which means fulfilling all the needs that we have in life with our free will. And also self-actualization also means the reaching of attainment of the fullest potential of an individual. Fullest potential of full talents, making use of our skills to the maximum, and realizing whom we really are, really realizing and attaining all our potentials, all our skills, all our talents, and attaining all our needs also. That is what we actually call self-actualization, becoming the actual self, self-actualization. Okay, this is the Maslow's hierarchy of needs, Abraham Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Okay, Amal, continue.
Next, I am here to take about the conjunctive person.
I told you it's not conjunctive, it's cognitive. Say once more, cognitive. Amal? It is cognitive. Okay, continue. Continue, please. There was a technical issue in between, children. Please wait. Okay, continue.
They are telling about the cognitive perspective. During the 1960s, a new perspective known as cognitive psychology.
Again, cognitive. Yes.
Cognitive psychology began to take hold. It focused on mental process. This area of psychology is concerned with memory, thinking, problem solving, language and decision making. Influenced by psychologists such as Jean Piaget and Albert Bandura, this perspective has won relevancy in recent decades.
That's John Piaget.
Yes.
It's not Piaget, it's Jean Piaget.
Piaget. Yes.
Continue.
The cognitive perspective is the psychological viewpoint that focuses on the how people and other animals process, store, and retrieve information and how this information is used to reason and solve problems. What is principles of cognitive? The principle that guide and resist cognitive operation, they operated within and across different cognitive models, vision, languages, etc. Definition of cognitive perceptive. The cognitive perceptive is concerned with mental functions such as memory, perceptions, etc. Example of cognitive. Example. Nasir started college last summer and has not been able to improve her grades as much as her friends think she could. What they know is that their family herself is not studying. What is the main focus of cognitive perceptive? Cognitive refers to mental activity, including thinking, remember, learn, and using language. When we apply cognitive approach to learning and teaching, we focus on what they, about the students' information and the concepts.
Processing of information.
What are the basic concepts of cognitive perceptive? Traditionally, cognitive psychology include human perceptive, attention, learning, memory, concept formation, reasoning, judgment, and decision making, problem solving, and language processing. What does cognitive perceptive? What cognitive perceptive?
Perspective.
Approaching that emphasize mental process in perceptive memory, language, solving other problems and helping them to solve, to make good behavior. Three main cognitive theories. Egan, cognitive development theory, socio-culture theory, and information person theory.
There are different theories under cognitive perspective. Okay, one is Jean Piaget's cognitive development theory, Vygotsky's theory, also all such theories are there. Okay, then.
Daily life, you know about what cognitives. There are numerous practical applications for this cognitive research, such as provides helping coping with memory disorders, increasing decision making, finding ways to help people recover from brain injury, treating learning disorders, and structuring educational curriculum to enhance learning.
Okay, then.
Next about convention.
Constructivism. Or cognition. Which one?
Cognition.
Okay.
Cognition, how people think about themselves and the social world, or more especially how people say interpret, remember, and use social information to make judgment and decisions. The assumption is that people are generally trying to form accurate impressions of the world and so do so much of the time. Because of the nature of social thinking, however, people sometimes from earnest impressions. Automatic thinking, who can automatic without thinking, thinking that is non-conscious, conditioned, evaluated, and effortless. thinking is afforded and deliberate pausing to think about self and environment carefully, selecting the right course of action. Cognition is referring to mental process involving gaining knowledge and comprehensions.
Okay.
This cognitive process including thinking, knowing, remembering. Definition of cognition is defined as the mental action or process of acquiring knowledge and understanding through thought, experiences and the senses.
Okay, all aspects of your mental life, the thinking process, all that is involved under the topic cognition. Remembering, thinking, knowing, then decision making, problem solving, perception, everything is a part of cognition. Okay, then.
Cognition defined in psychology. Study of the mind and how we think. Learning is example of cognition. The way our brain makes connection as we learn concepts in different ways to remember what we have learned. Our ability to reason through logic is a prime example of cognitive modules. Cognition is the same as intelligence. In brief, cognition and intelligence are two individual concepts. Cognition is the mental process of acquiring knowledge and understanding through and while intelligence is ability to learn or understanding things and deal with now or difficult situations.
Okay.
What are the elements in cognition? Cognition includes several elements or processes that all work to describe how our knowledge is built upon and our judgment or model. Which came first? Cognition. Historically, it has been assumed that effect is past. Cognition means that effect occurs as a result of the person, therefore after. What is the principle of cognition? The series on the cognitive principle of affective teaching consists of five short videos, mindset, unconvention and trust. Then every day, cognition refers to ability to solve cognitively complex tasks of daily life. Next, I'm here to tell about constructivism. Benefits of constructivism. Children enjoy and learn more when they are actively involved rather than passively listening. Education works best when it constrains on thinking and understanding rather than on rote memorism. Constructivist learning is
transferable. Continue.
Constructive learning is transferable. Students create organizing principle that they can take to other learning settings. Constructivists give students ownership of what they learn, and often the students have hand-decided assessment as well. Engaging the creative insight develops students' ability to express knowledge through the variety of ways. Students are more likely to retain and transfer the new knowledge to real life. Students learn to question things and apply their nature curiosity to the world.
Okay.
Constructive promotes social competence skills by creating an environment that embraces scholarship and exchange of ideas. Constructive is important learning theory that educators use to help their students learn constructively based on the idea that people actually constrain or make their own knowledge and reality is determined by your own experience as a learner. Concept of constructivism. Constructivism is the theory that says learners construct knowledge rather than just passively take in information as people experience that would and reflect upon this experience. Example of constructivism. An elementary school teacher presents a glass problem to measure the length of a maybe what the teacher allows students to reflect and to construct their own matter of concern. What are the daily life of constraints? Classism, respect teach learning, engage learning and problem based
Okay.
learning. Corporate. Thank you. I hope you will enjoy this seminar.
Okay. All right. Very good, Amil. You have elaborated on so many schools of psychology, but make sure you learn the correct pronunciation, okay, of certain words. You have to make sure your slides are organized also. Some are here and there, and some lag headings. So make sure you make up for that next time. Okay, Amal? Okay, you can ask one question to these people now. Amal, any one question, fast. Others, switch on the video.
What is psychoanalysis?
What is psychoanalysis? What is the main focus of that? Anyone? Fast, fast. What is the main focus of psychoanalysis? Something starting with U.
It is a method of psychotherapy where the therapist tries to bring the
unconscious
mind into consciousness.
Yes, right. Main focus is on unconscious motives, unconscious memories, unconscious desires of individuals. Okay. Yes, and it was brought about by Sigmund Freud. That's the main concept. Okay, now who will ask? Abhinav, can you ask one question to him back?
Okay,
simple
ma'am.
Question.
Ma'am, what is cognitive?
What is
cognitive
perspective? What is cognitive perspective, Amal? Amal Roshan, what is cognitive perspective? I think again he has a network issue. Amal, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what is cognitive perspective? Answer fast. To stop the class.
Cognitive perspective is a psychological viewpoint that focus on the how people and other people behaves.
Behaves, things, basically.
Aspects, structures were compared and led to the development of cognitive perspective, which focus on how we know about the world.
How we know about the world, yes. The different process like thinking, knowing, problem solving, decision making, remembering, learning, all these processes, the information processing model, all those comes under cognitive perspective. Okay. All right. We'll wind up the class. Thank you. And there will be a test on Friday, the coming Friday, from first chapter. Okay. We have 2 hours on Friday. On either of the hour, I'll take a test on first chapter. I'll tell you in the coming classes how will the test be, in which are the main portions and all. Okay, thank you.